Okay, dear students, so let us discuss about the greedy method, the 0-1 knapsack using the greedy method. Okay, in this approach, the decision is taken on the basis of the current available information without worrying about the effect of the current decision in future. The greedy algorithm build a solution part by part, choosing the next part in such a way that it gives an immediate benefit. This approach never reconsiders the choice taken previously. In many problems, the greedy algorithms fails to find an optimal solution. Moreover, it may produce a worst solution. The problems like traveling salesman and knapsack cannot be solved using this approach. So again, now we are considering here 0-1 knapsack. As we know, in this the items cannot be broken, which means the thief should take the item as a whole or he should leave it. This is the reason behind calling it as 0-1 knapsack. Hence, in the case of 0-1 knapsack, the value of xi can be either 0 or 1, whether that is where other constraints remain the same. The knapsack cannot be solved by the greedy approach. That is, greedy approach does not ensure an optimal solution. In many instances, greedy approach may give an optimal solution also, okay, but not in all the cases. So let us consider the examples, okay. So here, for example, here if I consider the objects ABC and the corresponding profit and the weight, okay, here if I follow the selection of the items depending on the ratio value, that is speed, profit of the current object divided by the weight of the object, okay, then we can arrange the object like this. So initially here it will select the object A, and the given knapsack capacity is 60 for this example, okay. So if the object A is taken, its weight is 10, so remaining weight will be 50, so it will select the next object B, okay, that is 40. So totally now the knapsack is filled with the two objects A and B with the profit 380, and the total capacity filled up is 50, so remaining is 10. So when it moves to the third object C, okay, depending on again this ratio value, so here the weight is 20, where it cannot fit into the knapsack bag. So the optimal solution for this A and B is 380. But when we see for other solution, okay, if it selects the object B and C with a weight 40 and 20, it exactly fits the knapsack bag with a capacity 60, and its total profit will be 400, which is compared with the selecting the object A and B. So the greedy algorithm fails in this to provide the optimal solution. Okay, so the 0-1 knapsack problem using the greedy method is again implemented using the Java language here. So we have the knapsack class. Inside the constructor of the knapsack, okay, we are initializing the weight and the profit ratio value. That is, we are allocating the memory for all these things, and we are reading the number of items required for the knapsack problem. Okay, the weight of the number of items to be filled in the knapsack is stored in the variable n. Okay, and the weight and the profit array will be initialized with the size of, okay, which is equal to the number of items. And using the for loops, okay, we will be reading the weight value and the profit value corresponding to the particular item. Okay, so, and also we are reading the capacity of the knapsack. Okay, and here we have the two methods, fill and the get next method. So here the fill is called to fill up the knapsack bag, okay, and the get next method is called to find out which object to be put into the knapsack. Okay, so here we have the class, that is main method. We are creating the object of the knapsack and invoking the method fill. Okay, so when the fill method is called, okay, here in the fill thing, we are finding the ratio, okay, that is the profit of the each object divided by the weight of the object. Okay, so we will be arranging the objects in that order, okay, in descending order of the profit divided by the weight. So each item will be selected depending on this ratio value. Okay, so now if you want to fill up inside the knapsack bag, obviously I have to check what is the current weight I have, okay, with the total capacity of the bag. If the current weight is lesser than the total capacity of the knapsack bag, then only I can insert the one more item into the bag. So while loop will run, okay, till the current weight is lesser than capacity, otherwise it will come out of the while loop. So inside the while loop, okay, we will be finding the which method to fill up using the get next method. Okay, so in the get next method, okay, here I will be accessing the ratio array. Okay, ratio array is containing what? It is the ratio value of the profit of the each object divided by the weight of the object. Okay, so initially highest variable will be 0. Then we keep on updating the highest value depending on the ratio of the I. Okay, if the ratio of that particular object is greater than the highest value, then we will be exchanging the value, that is highest is equal to ratio. Then the index of that particular I will be returning, that is the index represent which object to insert inside the knapsack. So that index value will be returned by the next get next method. Okay, that what we have called in the fill method. So once the item is found, okay, then we'll be adding the weight of that particular item what we have got with the current weight. If the summation is lesser than or equal to the capacity of the knapsack, then I will be updating the variable. That is, I will be adding the weight of that object what we have got with the current weight, and also the profit we will be updating. That means by selecting that particular item, what is the profit we are getting now, and how much of the knapsack bag is filled up. That is represented using the current weight variable. And also we have one more array, that is a solution vector of the item. We will be setting that to 1, indicating that particular item we have selected. So solution vector with respect to the index item, we will be setting it as 1. Okay, so item is the value what we have got from the next method, that is the item, which item we have got, that we are representing the solution vector. Okay, corresponding to that particular item index in the solution vector, we will be setting the value equal to 1. Okay, and we will be making the ratio of that particular item in the ratio will be equal to 0. Okay, otherwise if the current weight plus the current weight of the item what we have selected is not lesser than or equal to capacity, okay, I will be making the solution vector of item is equal to 0. That means we are telling we will be not selecting that particular item. Okay, and we can make ratio of the item is equal to 0. So then finally we will be printing the solution vector, that is the maximum profit whatever we have got. Okay, then the which are all the objects we have selected, okay, by printing the content of the solution vector. Okay, this is the 01 knapsack by using the greedy method. Okay, so as an example here we have the 4 items, and the weight of the each item is given 10, 40, 20 and 10. The profit is 100, 280, 120 and 10. Okay, and the knapsack capacity is 60. Fine. So we will call the fill method. Inside the fill method, okay, I will access the get next method. That is, so before that I will be initializing the ratio value. So ratio is for the first object is 100 divided by 10, next 280 by 40, next 120 by 20, for the next item 10 by 10, that is equal to 1. So initially we have the ratio item here. Okay, so inside the while loop I will check, and initially the current weight will be initialized to 0. This 0 is lesser than 60, so while loop will execute. Inside the while loop, okay, I will be checking for the next item. So that is, in the next item method I will be checking for the ratio value. Okay, highest is initialized to 0 initially, then this highest value will keep on updating. How to update the highest variable? So I will move through the ratio array finding the value. So initially I have the 10 in the ratio. Okay, I will compare this 10 value whether it is greater than the height value, that is 0. So 10 is greater than 0, so highest value will get modified as highest is equal to 10, and index of this I is 0. Okay, we will be executing this inside the for loop for I is equal to 0 to lesser than n. Okay, so next ratio value is 7. Is it 7 is greater than 10? No. Similarly, 6 with the 10 compared, 1 with the 10 will be compared. So, in all these things, the highest value we have got 10 will keep remains the same. And index of this is 0. That means we are telling the item to be selected is at the position 0. That is the first item we are going to select. So, once the first item is selected, now the weight of that item is considered, that is the 10. That 10 will be added with the initial current weight, that is 0. I will compare 0 plus 10, whether it is lesser than or equal to 60. Yes, 10 is lesser than or equal to 60. So now I will update the current weight. Okay, that is current weight is equal to current weight plus weight of the item. That is 0 plus 10 is equal to 10. Then profit is equal to 0 plus 100. That is equal to 100. And I will be setting the solution vector at the index item is equal to 1. So here we have for the item 0, solution vector we are setting it as 1. Okay, and we will be making ratio of the item is equal to 0. Okay, so this is done. Now again, we will continue with the while loop. Now again, the current capacity is what? 10, what we have got in the previous iteration. That will be compared with the 60. Yes, 10 is lesser than 60. Now in the get next method, I will be checking inside the ratio array to get the next item to be added into the knapsack. So again, I will initialize the highest variable is equal to 0. Okay, and here 0 is greater than 0 is false. Next, 7 is greater than 0 is true. So I will set highest is equal to 7. The index of this variable is index is equal to 1. Okay, similarly, the remaining values present in the ratio array will be compared with the highest value 7. So I will not get any other highest value. So highest is equal to 7 remains the same. Index of that is index is equal to 1. That means we are telling the item to be selected is the 1. So now once this item is got, I will check the current weight plus the weight of this particular item 1, that is 10 plus 40, whether it is lesser than or equal to 60. Yes, it is lesser than or equal to 60 because 50 is lesser than or equal to 60. So I will update the current weight. That is the previous current weight is 10 plus 40. 50 I will get. The total profit is 100 plus 280, which is equal to 380. Okay, the profit of the current item 1 is 280, that is 380 I will be getting. And also I will set the solution vector of that particular item 1 is equal to 1, as we are seeing here. And I will make ratio of that particular item is equal to 0. Okay, so next again the while loop will continue. In the third iteration, the current weight is lesser than the knapsack capacity 60. Yes. Then fetch the next item inside the ratio array. So in the ratio array I will be getting here the 6 is greater than 0. Yes, so I will set highest is equal to 6. Okay, index of this is equal to 2. Okay, that means we are getting the item is equal to 2 to be added into the knapsack. So I will get the weight of this particular item 2, that is 50 plus 20. The previous value of the current weight is 50. Now the current value of this object is 20. 50 plus 20 is lesser than or equal to 60. This condition will become false because 70 is not lesser than or equal to 60. So therefore the else part inside the while loop will be executed. Okay, that is inside that we will be making the solution vector of the item is equal to 0 and the ratio of the item is equal to 0. That means when we are setting solution vector of the item is equal to 0, that indicates we are not selecting that particular item. That means we are not selecting the second item. So solution vector is equal to 0 at that for the index 2 we will be doing. Okay, so next again while loop continues. Now the current, that means here in these iterations we have not updated any current weight or the current profit. Okay, because we have not selected this particular item 2. So now again the current weight is compared with the 60 inside the while loop, the condition becomes true. So I will search for the next item, that is the fourth item will be selected because I will get 1 is greater than 0, that is present at the index is equal to 3 in the ratio array. Okay, that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So item 3 is selected now. Now again the weight of that item 3 will be added with the current weight to check whether it is lesser than or equal to 60. Yes, 50 plus 10 is equal to 60 if condition becomes true. So I will update the current weight and the current profit. That is current weight is 50 plus weight of this particular object 3 is 10, so I will be getting 60, and profit will be 380 plus 10, that is equal to 390. Okay, so solution, I will make solution vector of that particular item is equal to 1, that is solution vector of the 3 is equal to 1 I will be setting. Fine. So now again I will the while loop will continue. Okay, so now in the while loop, again the current weight is 60, I have 60 is not lesser than the knapsack capacity 60, the condition become false, that means while loop will terminate. Then finally we will be displaying the output, that is we will be printing the current profit, that is 390, and also the solution vector, okay, telling which are all the items we have selected. Okay, so we have selected the item 1, 2 and that is 4, but we have not selected the item 3. Okay, so but here we have got the solution with the profit 390, but we also have another solution, that is here another solution for this example is obtained by selecting the item 2 and 3 also, that is its weight is 40 plus 20 is equal to 60. This also fill up the knapsack item 2 and 3, totally giving the profit 400. Okay, so but here by selecting the 3 items, item 1, 2 and 4, I am getting 390. But here I can also have one more solution by selecting only 2 items, that is the item 2 and 3, okay, filling the total weight of the knapsack with the profit 400, more compared with the solution what we have got. Okay, so that means here this is an example to show the greedy method, okay, for the 01 knapsack will not give the optimal solution. Okay, that is it can also give, with it would have given this solution 400 profit, but now we are getting 390. Fine. So that is this is the one example for the greedy method using the that is 01 knapsack using the greedy method. Okay, so here in the program we have this portion to print the maximum profit what we have got once the while loop terminates, okay, and also the solution vector content. Okay, so this is using the greedy method to solve the 01 knapsack. Okay. Thank you, students.